has said that an entrepreneur is like a soldier. When you go into battlefield, you don't know whether you will win or come back in a body bag. But there is tons of passion, there is tons of commitment to make something happen. And then for each of those very successful entrepreneurs, you think of Bill Gates or Mark Zuckerberg, there are thousands of people who are finding it difficult to put food on the table. And yet we need to keep in mind that entrepreneurship is what drives commerce and economy. You know, a big company will never take risk. They will always play safe. It is a small guy, people like you and me, who will come up with a brilliant idea. And we will risk all that we have to try and make it successful. So this book is a tribute to entrepreneurship. Everybody big and small. Everybody has been successful. Everybody is trying to be successful. Everybody will someday be successful. So to me, this book is a distilled wisdom of 10 years of Home India that Sanjay and I ran. And we hope that some of the wisdom nuggets that we came through in our learnings become useful to other inspiring entrepreneurs. Right.
So, while Harish gave an overall summary of what this book is about, to give you a more specific context, so Harish and I, as Alvin mentioned, we went to college together, we went to the engineering school together, we went to the US together. But after coming back, we were in our own family businesses until one fateful dinner or dinner that was destined to be. This was unlike a lot of startups which we see today, when guys coming out of an IIT or a JTI have this big idea and they get together and they want to get a startup going. Ours was a startup by accident. We were having dinner together with another friend who had come from the US, and we just expressed maybe a little sort of concern that maybe our creative juices were not getting its way, a vent in our family businesses. We wanted to do something more. Normally all these conversations happen on a dinner table and then you go back to your work and nothing comes out of it. But destiny had something else ordained for us. That fateful dinner and today, it's been a journey for both of us. It started that day and we met a few times and Home India happened, and of course we've been together for our second startup also, which is Social Gaming and Mirror. So the book talks about how it all began and then what was the initial business. The initial business, we decided that we'll get out of our family businesses, but we will not take any money. We will bootstrap the business. So bootstrapping in the real sense of the word, starting with zero capital, what is the kind of business you can get started, and from there to creating a product company like homeindia.com, scaling it, and you know, finding venture capital and probably hitting some rough waters because of the dot-com bust, then finding a way to still make it survive and return to profitability, and then at some point having to exit out of it. That's the whole journey. It was clearly a roller coaster ride. It was, it had lots and lots of pivots. Pivot is a popular word in today's startup jargon. We did not call it pivot in those days, but we kept kind of morphing the business from one point to the other. And all that is an interesting journey. So we realized that while whatever happened in terms of our personal, let's say, capital growth, or it didn't happen as much as we would have liked to, there was so much which happened for us in those 9 years, and so much ups and downs that we went through, that there was a story in it which we thought we should tell. And in that story, while it's our personal story, there were lots and lots of learnings which we can call as wisdom nuggets, which we think will be useful to other startup founders or wannabe entrepreneurs. And that's what led us to write this book.
Thank you very much.